Hello and welcome to Networking Simplify. My name is Alimul Haq. This time I am going to explain how two computers connected to a layer 2 switch communicate with each other in detail. In this video tutorial, I will try to explain address resolution protocol and layer 2 switching in details with example. This tutorial might be helpful for the CCNA students who want to have a basic understanding of the operations that a frame undergoes as it passes through a layer 2 switch. This will help to get a firm grasp on how to configure a switch for complex functions. I have made this tutorial in two parts. In the first part, I will explain a bit about layer 2 switching and address resolution protocol process. In part 2, I will demonstrate this with practical step-by-step example. Address resolution protocol. One of the tools used almost every day in almost every TCP/IP network in the world to help the network layer with its task of routing from end to end through an internetwork. A sending host knows the IP address of the destination host, but not the MAC address. It must determine the MAC address before any communication between the source and destination host can occur. The sending host creates and sends a frame address to a broadcast MAC address. This is called ARP request. Contained in the message with the IP address of the intended destination host. Each host on the network receives the broadcast frame and only the host with the matching IP address sends its MAC address back to the original host. The original host receives the message and stores the MAC address and IP address information in a table called ARP table. Any device that uses IP should retain or cache the information learned with ARP, placing the information in its ARP cache or ARP table. Each time a host needs to send a packet encapsulated in an Ethernet frame, it first checks its ARP table and uses the MAC address found there. If the correct information is not listed in the ARP cache, the host then can use ARP to discover the MAC address used by a particular IP address. Also, a host learns ARP information when receiving an ARP as well. Hosts may or may not need to ARP to find the destination host's MAC address based on the two-step routing logic used by a host. If the destination is on the same subnet, the sending host sends an ARP looking for the destination host's MAC address. However, if the sending host is on a different subnet than the destination host, the sending host's routing logic results in the sending host needing to forward the packet to its default gateway. Now, I will explain a bit about layer 2 switching logic. The role of a layer 2 switch is to forward Ethernet frames. To achieve that goal, switches use logic based on the source and destination MAC address in each frame's Ethernet header. There are three general categories of Ethernet MAC addresses: unicast addresses, broadcast addresses, multicast addresses. The primary job of a LAN switch is to receive Ethernet frames and then make a decision either to forward the frame out some other ports or ignore the frame based on the destination MAC address. The second main function of a switch is to learn the MAC addresses and its associated interfaces to put into its address table. Broadcast and multicast frames are flooded out to all ports except the one that receives the frame. Frames destined for unknown locations are flooded out to all ports except the one that receives the frame. When a new host sends a message or responds to a flooded message, the switch immediately learns its MAC address and the port to which it is connected. In the second part of the tutorial, I will show how two PCs connected to a layer 2 switch in the same subnet communicate with using ARP and layer 2 switching process.